Hello, I'm Jonathan, a software engineer at Fluree. Welcome to our video showcasing how Fluree's data platform can be used in a secure master data management environment, leveraging concepts of unbreakable identity and access management, as well as schematically enforced data governance. Master data management systems concern themselves with providing a single source of truth for an organization's data, generally spread across multiple departments and sources. This demo only uses one data source, the Fluree ledger, to demonstrate how users with different job functions might collaborate in a secure, fast-paced environment. Identity and access management is a key part of creating this secure environment, ensuring that users are not accessing or changing data that is not appropriate to their role in the organization. User authentication provides verification that a user is who they say they are. Authorization defines what a user can do in the context of an application or environment. Roles are often based on a user's position or job function within an organization. These roles are granted appropriate authorizations. Unlike most existing MDM and IAM applications, Fluree does not rely on external APIs or applications to apply these concepts. The data defends itself using features built directly into the platform. These Fluree-specific features include the roles collection, the rules collection, smart functions, and the password-based authentication API. So for this demo, we're going to have two roles, salespeople and accountants. These will be simulating two different departments using the same app, and our roles will have different data permissions based on the job function. For example, you want a salesperson to be able to access lots of client data, but you don't want them to be able to see sensitive banking information that an accountant might need to do their job. So as far as things that are allowed for the sales role, they have access to all client types. They can create contracts. They can update a contract that is issued by them, and they can change a client's deal status from, say, customer or prospect to customer to lapsed customer. The accountant role can view and transact clients' bank account data. They can transact payments for clients. Some things that are not allowed include, for the sales role, they cannot query or transact bank accounts, transact payments. Accountants can't query clients that aren't customers or transact contracts. The most basic building block for data security in Fluree is the smart function, indicated by these small circles down at the bottom. These functions can be applied in a manner of different ways, including the predicate slash transaction spec predicate or the collection slash spec predicate. This method of applying smart functions works schema-wide and does not take into account user roles. For identity access management, we use the rule collection and the role collection. So in the functions predicate of our particular rule record or rule subject, we will apply various smart functions, including the most basic one, the true function, that will grant access to any collection and predicates that are included in the particular rule that the functions are being applied to. These rules are then aggregated into a role subject, which then is applied to a user attached to their auth slash roles predicate. All of these work in conjunction to allow various transaction and query permissions to be used by each user based on their role. We have three important custom smart functions that are enforcing certain rules in our database schema. The first one we'll go into is the isContractIssuedBy smart function. This enforces the rule that a salesperson can only edit or update a contract that is issued by them. So the basic question it's asking is, was the contract issued by the user who is attempting to update the contract? This will use the built-in relationship function and will determine if there's a link between the user reference in the contract slash issued by predicate and the auth ID of the user attempting the transaction. Then it is applied via the contract collections spec predicate. So this means it will be executed, this smart function will be executed for every attempted transaction on the contract collection, regardless of that user's role. Our next smart function is the isClientCustomer function. It's a pretty simple one. It determines, is a client who is being queried a customer? It uses the relationship built-in function again, and it determines if there is a link between the specified subject and the customer tag. Then it is attached to the client collection as a query rule for accountants, and that rule is then added to the accountant roles rules predicate. Our last custom smart function is the can add bank account. This one asks the question, is the owner of the bank account a customer? It again uses the relationship built-in function to determine a link between the specified subject and the customer tag. Then it is applied to a rule that attaches it to the bank accounts collection and set as a transaction rule and attached to the accountant's rules predicate. So let's take a moment to get our demo app started up. I'm in a folder with a recently downloaded version of the Fluree ledger. It's a blank instance of Fluree. So I'll get started up with our command. Give it a moment to get going. Now we're in the root folder for the demo app repo. Run npm install if you just cloned it. And npm start to begin our developer server. When the app mounts, it will look for an instance of Fluree running, and if there is one, it will query and see if the required ledger is present. If not, it will bootstrap that ledger and transact all of our schema and a little bit of seed data. So let's register a user. So we'll start with some salespeople. Register them. And so this is our basic dashboard. Right now there are no contracts, which is why there are no contracts visible. You can go to clients. You can add a client. And we'll make them a customer. Voila, transacted. Let's add a lapsed customer. So one of the things that a salesperson can do is they can query payments, but they cannot transact payments. So we'll do that real quick. Jimmy James is the only person with a bank account. You will note that the salesperson cannot see anything except for the bank account owner and the ID in the Fluree ledger. So, but they cannot even transact a payment because of their permissions in the Fluree schema. Salesperson, however, can transact contracts, which are going to do one right now. So we will do a contract for Beth, say in the amount of $89 million, 22 cents. There, we have a contract. We go down here, open up this contract. We can edit it however we want. There we go. Now let's see how this works with another salesperson. We have Dwight, and he can see all the contracts, payments, clients. Let's add a new contract. There, we've added another contract. So we have Dwight here. Let us attempt to edit Jim's contract. Let's change that date to start at the beginning of next month, we'll find that Dwight cannot edit Jim's contract. However, if we switch to the one that was provided, that was issued by Dwight, he can indeed change that. Now let's move over to our accounting role. All right, old Benjamin the accountant is in. As you can see, we have bank account access now for the accountant. You might notice here that an accountant can only see clients that are classified as customers, which leads to, within the app, they can only add bank accounts for customers. And then they can transact payments. We have our newly created account, and we will make a payment. Accountants can query contracts, but they cannot transact them. And they also cannot edit them. So you might ask, how do these smart functions even know how to find who a user is? When a user logs in or registers a user using the Fluree password API, upon a successful registration or login, they are sent a JSON web token that is stored and then sent with every request to the Fluree ledger as an authorization header. This is an example of a token returned, and you will find in the subject is the auth ID of the user. So this is accessed in Fluree, and then Fluree can use that to determine a user's role based on the role that is attached to that user's auth record. Fluree's password API and the JWT tokens they issue are incredibly powerful and dynamic. And if you want to know a bit more about them, our video on the password API would be a great resource, so we've linked it in the description below. Hopefully, this demo has given you some idea of Fluree's potential in the master data management and identity and access management space. Current MDM systems rely on applications, hard-coded APIs, and redundant data sources, like data lakes, silos, etc., to function. With Fluree, data permissions can be enforced in the data layer, simplifying enterprise architecture and reducing the costs and risks commonly associated with MDM solutions. This allows for applications to be built around an original data source without the risk of that source returning something it should not. If you're a developer or just someone who's interested in how this works on a more technical level, or you want to play around with the demo app, feel free to check out the GitHub repository linked in the description. If you have any questions about what you've seen in this video, the best place to start is Fluree's Slack channel, where you can ask the community or DM me at FlurryJonathan.